Okay, we get the Samsung banner in here behind me. The press guys, bring in your gear, boys. Whack your tape recorders down here. Okay, I'll whack up the Samsung hat here, Bungie.
What's going on?
Now, what we're going to do, Jimmy and Plugger. Now, this is, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be very serious now because we're talking about one of the greatest full forwards of all time. Will make a decision on his AFL football career.
You've just made a mockery of it by organising a press conference.
Well, the boys have been waiting, mate. It's been going
no,
a long time.
No, you're right. We did say we'd make a decision tonight, and the time has come. I can't put it off any longer. And I certainly hope everyone understands my decision. But as of this weekend, I'll play this weekend. But then I'll be retiring from league football. So this weekend will be my last game. I've had a hell of a lot of well wishes, who, particularly Hawthorn supporters, who have wanted me to play on for a year. And I know you keep telling me to play on for a year, but it's got to a very difficult stage. The injuries over the last couple of years. I've had in the last 2 years two knee reconstructions and a broken collarbone. It starts to take its toll. Well, it's not only on yourself but also on the family. And I just think that when you weigh up the pros and cons of playing another year, it just seemed to me to be the right time to get out.
Well, go on, Jimmy.
Will Hawthorn be giving? Is there any tributes
send
to Hawthorn
going
to give to you?
Yeah, most
laps
certainly.
Laps of the Oval, or what's the story?
Well, I couldn't do a lap of the Oval if I tried at the moment, James. I haven't trained for a while. But we're actually having a function back at Glenfree Oval. That's between 6:30 and 8:30 after the match. If you want to come back and celebrate with me and also the rest of the players and the coaching staff, 6:30 to 8:30 at Glenfree Oval. It's a bit of a sausage sizzle and drinks, just the family-type style
anyone,
things we do at Hawthorn.
Anyone, Jase, that you may want to thank while you got the opportunity maybe tonight?
Well, look, there's a heap of people. Obviously, it's just got the stage where if I played, it would be one more year. And the way the training schedule is now, you would have to devote all your time to that. And with what I'm doing here at Channel 7 and also at Triple M, it's just become too hard to do both. And it's impossible to, I think, sacrifice all of what I'm going to do in the future for one more year of footy. So I do hope people understand that. But I would like to thank, look, first of all, my family and friends who have been great support over the years. To everyone at the Hawthorn Football Club, everyone that I've been involved with has been absolutely fantastic. To the supporters, look, the supporters have been absolutely sensational for 14 years. They've been with us through thick and thin. We had a lot of good times. Last few years we've had, some very, very ordinary times, but they've been there. In actual fact, we now have the highest supporter base in Melbourne. And that's something that absolutely thrills me. But I think I'm leaving the club in good hands, and I guess the people I'll miss the most when it all comes down to it, and the thing I'll miss the most about not playing next year is not the training, nothing like that, but it'll be the teammates, you're right. Mm. The guys that you've spent all that time with, that you've worked so hard with, the camaraderie that you've built over the years, the going out, the training hard, all the different things you do, going on footy camps and slaving your guts out. You wouldn't trade that for anything. And I can honestly say in the 14 years I've played of league footy, you couldn't wish for a better 14 years of your life.
What do you think, Plugger? Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah, look.
What do you think?
Yeah, look.
What do you think, Cohen, on the great career?
It's obviously been a very tough decision for Jason, and it's one that he's now made. And, I've thoroughly enjoyed our friendly rivalry over... Well, you know, I've been 16 years now, and Jason about the same. And you know, I don't think there was a week that went by that I didn't say to someone, "How did Hawthorn go? How many did Jason Dunstall kick?" You know,
I always looked up the paper on a Sunday.
I was always keen to find out how many Jason kicked. You know, and I think we've pushed each other for a lot of years now.
Do you know what I really used to hate about that? They plug it. You'd have a really good game. You kick 10, you go, "I reckon I've kicked away from him." You read the paper, he's kicked 12.
You just stole me along, because that's what I was going to say.
Oh, I
but
that.
Look, I'm certainly going to miss it, mate. Look, I wish you all the best in retirement. I know how hard it is. It's certainly very hard. I think I was on the physio table for about an hour tonight getting 100,000 service. And, it's very hard week after week to keep coming up, mate. But, look, I congratulate you. You've been fantastic, not only for the club, but for the game itself, mate, and I just wish you all the best.
Well, you've got to make me one promise. One promise. We've been closing in on Coventry's record for a long time. You've got to blow it away and set a record that no one else will ever get near.
Mate, I'll do it for you.
Congratulations. Big
just one more quick one between you and Tony. What was it like when you played together for Victoria? I think it may have been 89 MCG and 90,000.
That was fantastic. Yep. We had 90,000 there.
There it is here.
I think I actually passed that to the big fella. How's the hair there, Plugger? It's looking all right, isn't
mate,
it?
I don't come up real good in the wide shorts,
no.
Do I?
No, we never liked playing away. It made our bums look bigger. But he returns the favour. He'll tap one here from the ruck. Straight to yours truly.
Straight to the top.
Could have been
right. Look at that.
Could have been right.
No,
It will go down as you know, certainly one of the great memories I'll get out of the game was to, you know, to play with alongside Jason in 89. I think it was the first time that we had a state game in Victoria for a long time, and there was a huge crowd there, and we had a real good win, and you know, I think we kicked four or five each, and you know, it just capped off a fantastic day.
Do you remember when we were in training? We were actually training for that, and there was the big debate over whether the two full forward system would work.
Yeah.
And you came up to me at training one night and said, "This is ridiculous, stuff it. I'm going to tell the selectors they can stick it. It's got to be one of us, not the two." And then we had a team dinner, I reckon, two nights later, and you got up and said, "I reckon this will work great, the two full forwards working together." Now, I want to know what was said to you by who to make you turn around like that.
I just realised that if you'd done all the leading, I could just sit back in the aisle square, you know.
Okay.
It did work beautifully.
Well, it worked fantastic.
Sorry, Tom. Well done, Bungie. Fantastic. Thanks, mate. And Jimmy, as you know, we've put a bit of a package together, Bungie, of your brilliant career over the 14 years. On behalf of the people of Australian football, to you, Bungie, you're a superstar, mate.
Is it all good?
This footage is absolutely fantastic.
Is it all good, though?
Just watch this, son. It is fantastic. You remember me when the west wind moves upon the fields of barley. You forget the sun in his jealous sky. We walk in fields of gold.
Dunstall with one hand. What a contest.
Will you stay with me? Will you be my love? Among the fields of body.
We'll Dunstall in the pocket, goes for gold, up to 100 and gets it.
As the Hawthorn champ from 45 metres, kicks penalties.
Now, Dougie, I thought I was supposed to be the one crying.